Good morning, this is Martha Headroom, and welcome to the Jamaican Business News Summary, a weekly program of business-related news. A sonnet for modern times, a tale to tell of issues faced by drivers, stocks and bonds, and ventures halted due to highway bells that ring and bring delay with much ado. Driving lessons rise with rules enforced, instructors must comply, with fines to pay for those who teach without certification endorsed. And students must now sit in classrooms, hey. Investigations delve into a fraud where billions lost and stolen just as soft. And proven group seeks debt capital abroad with steady bonds despite rates that have brought. Melrose Hill Yam Park upgrade on hold due to highway changes, stall fees extolled. Thus, these three stories converge as one of business, laws, and progress all begun.
Driving lessons fees in Jamaica are expected to rise as certified driving instructors comply with the new Road Traffic Act. The new law requires instructors to provide classroom space and prohibits anyone from teaching someone to drive unless they are a certified, registered, and licensed instructor. Unlicensed driving schools face fines of $100,000. The rent for modest office space in Kingston can cost over $100,000 per month, leading instructors to pass the costs on their clients. Some instructors are supportive of the new law, which they believe will improve road safety, while others feel that the requirements will negatively impact their business and result in higher fees for clients.
The police have been working closely with prosecutors in a joint investigation into the Stocks and Securities Limited, SSL, fraud scandal. The investigation involves a number of domestic and international law enforcement agencies, including the Financial Investigations Division, the Fraud Squad, the Major Organized Crime and Anti-Corruption Agency, and the Federal Bureau of Investigation. Deputy Commissioner of Police Fitz Bailey stated that the investigation was making significant progress, although he declined to provide further details. It is estimated that approximately $3 billion has been stolen from dozens of account holders, including retired sprinter Usain Bolt, who has lost $2 billion. A former wealth advisor of SSL has reportedly admitted to stealing a large portion of the money. A search of two premises connected to her was carried out last month and resulted in the seizure of documents and electronic devices. The police continue to work closely with the prosecutors to gather evidence and bring the case to a close. Proven Group is seeking $10 million in debt capital through a two-year bond offer, paying 5.25% interest until maturity in January 2025. The bond, which will remain open for subscription until March 10, is intended for working capital and debt refinancing. The offer is restricted to accredited investors and arranged by Proven Wealth Limited on behalf of Proven Group. The company holds investments in wealth management, banking, microlending, manufacturing, and real estate ventures across the Caribbean. With total assets of $1 billion and a net value of $123 million, Proven Group is also in the process of setting up a wealth management arm in Barbados.
The Melrose Hill Yam Park Rehabilitation and Upgrade Project is on hold due to a delay in the completion of the Williamsfield Light of Highway 2000. The project was granted to concessionaire Kevin Frith's company Ideas Execution, which had planned to improve the facilities at the park, including stalls, restrooms, and the addition of a bar and car wash. Frith has already spent $2.5 million on the project, but the realignment of Section 1C of Highway 2000 took in a portion of the land earmarked for the project and caused delays. Business at the park has slowed as a result, and Frith has waived stall fees for vendors until the upgrade is completed.
That's all for now, and good night.